This is Lair Adams for the American Adversaries on WORL. In my closing tonight, I'd like to relate a tale of remarkable heroism. You may have heard this story or possibly seen some of several documentaries that have been produced about a man's courage. Oprah even talked about him. His name was Stephen Siller, and he was one of over 300 brave firefighters to lose his life when the Twin Towers collapsed on 9/11. I'm going to tell you some of the facts that we know about this man, this event, but much of this story is supposition, so please bear with me. Stephen was orphaned at age 10 and raised by his older siblings, especially his brother Russell, who was 24 years older. Imagine being 10 years old and losing your father. As fate would have it, his own daughter Katie would also lose her father at age 10. She wasn't alone. Stephen had a total of 5 children. The youngest, little Stephen, had recently undergone open-heart surgery, but like the father they would never really know, always seemed to have a smile on his face. It was a beautiful sunny day on the morning of September 11, 2001. Stephen was headed home from his night shift at a Brooklyn fire station and was shocked, as all of us were, to hear of the attack on the towers. Being a firefighter, I'm sure the knowledge these skyscrapers were burning jolted him into work mode. Any thoughts of returning home for rest, time with his wife and 5 kids, or even a relaxing game of golf were instantly erased. He turned his truck around and headed where all firefighters go when they get the call, into uncertainty. Stephen raced to the Brooklyn Battery Tunnel, only to find it completely blocked with panicked people headed away from where he had to go. He didn't need to think about what to do. He acted with the drive and skill of a dedicated professional firefighter. He abandoned his truck, grabbed his gear, 75 pounds of it, and headed into the tunnel. We can only imagine what was in Stephen's head as he ran as hard as he could through the nearly 2-mile tunnel. Was he thinking about his children, the birthdays, the diapers, the joys and heartaches of being an involved parent? Was he thinking about his wife, who was his best friend, lover, partner and mother of those wonderful children? As he darted around stopped cars filled with screaming, frightened strangers, did he think about his brothers and sisters that shared in raising him and who collectively he felt so close to? As the immobilizing cloud of panic filled that tunnel, did he think about his firefighter brothers that he had faced so many dangers with? I have to think these thoughts were on his mind. And again, the uncertainty. What would he find when he got there? Stephen had run over a mile, again carrying 75 pounds of gear, when he was picked up by a fire engine from station number 239. They drove him while he suited up to West Street near the towers and dropped him off. Incredibly, the fear and panic in the tunnel would be almost nothing compared to what he discovered at the base of those giant buildings. As he focused on the entrance, he saw his brother firefighters going in and out, carrying or leading those trapped inside to safety, doing what these brave people do, ignoring their own safety to help others. Imagine the horror of standing there with the crushed remains of people who had leapt from the upper floors all around you. Even worse, I'm sure he looked up and witnessed the free fall of even more jumpers, the people no one could save. There was no time to remove the bodies. There were the living to save. After witnessing this horror, who could blame a man, even an incredibly strong man, for not going inside what could be the mouth of death? However, Stephen was something bigger. He was a hero. Let's talk about that word, hero. Are heroes blessed with the ability to forget their loved ones as they dive into dangerous situations? Do they have an extra gene that makes them unafraid? No, that is for the reckless. Heroes are frightened of losing their lives, their families, their brothers. What makes them heroes is they choose to rise above what's best for them in order to help their fellow man. Every firefighter, police officer, and soldier knows the danger when they sign up for the job. So do their families. This makes them heroes too. Once inside, I'm sure Stephen Siller went to work, searching for anyone he could help. He may have run into Chuck Costello, an elevator repairman, who asked a friend to drop him off at ground zero when he heard of the disaster and felt he had to go into the building to help. He too was a true hero, and like Stephen, would never see his family again. Our story could end here, as Stephen Siller's body was never recovered. The family would never have his remains to mourn over. But this story continues. Each anniversary of 9/11 brings firefighters from all parts of America to New York to recreate Stephen's heroic efforts to reach his goal. The Tunnel to Towers Run is an event that grows every year as these brave servants gather to run the entire distance in full gear to acknowledge this man's spirit and heroism. There's that word hero again. I'm convinced if there is a hereafter, God has a special place for true heroes, because they represent one of his most beloved qualities, selflessness. Whether they are a soldier, cop, elevator repairman, or firefighter, they are the greatest example of the best mankind can be.